Mrs. Hinch. Mrs. Hinch, she says, looking over her spectacles, looking at you. Sophie, Soph.
Sometimes I forget that I am actually this Mrs. Hinch. I'm surprised people are not getting fed up with it.
No, but there's something so British about it, isn't there? Oh, I love it. And a bit coy and a bit like, oh, it's lovely, Mrs. Hinch. We all kind of, you know, there's the you with your feather duster image that is just gorgeous. Congratulations, the book is out. How does it feel?
It was out, it's scary. I genuinely still can't believe it. I didn't think I'd ever have a book, let alone it to sell as many copies as it has. I'm still in shock, if I'm honest, but I can't thank all of my Hinches enough for buying it and supporting me on it. It's just it's crazy, but a good crazy.
A good crazy. Yeah. Well, congratulations.
Thank
because
you.
I mean, I have a feeling. I mean, look, I've already got bits like folded down.
Oh, there are bookmarks.
Yeah, and I've got bookmarks of the bits that I'm going to go back to again and again and again. I've got a feeling that there's going to be a ragged copy of this in like 20 years' time in every household that you'll pass on to your daughters and your sons. Yeah, there you go. This is your guide for life when you go off into the world.
I was an author once back in the day. Imagine.
So the book then. Now this could have been a straight how-to guide. It could have been like a Haynes manual of how-to, but it's much, much more than that. Yeah. So how did it come to be so much more than, you know, I say just your tips, but more than just a guide?
I think what it is that I mean, I have so many direct messages come through on my Instagram from my followers. They're like hundreds of thousands, and I just wish I could read them all because they're just amazing. But a lot of the questions that come through, I was quite surprised that it wasn't just, okay, Mrs. Hinch, how do you get this stain out of the mattress? Or how do you do this? How do you do that? It's how do you focus or cope with this sort of problem? Or how? And they were really interested in not just Mrs. Hinch, but Sophie, and I was really couldn't believe it, because to me I've got the most sort of bog standard and what some people may call boring life. I was like, why are they, you know? But so what I've done is I've got this book, and I've done what my Hinches have asked for, and it's like Sophie, Mrs. Hinch, Hinching, cleaning, everything all in one. So it covers as much as I possibly could to give my Hinches what they were after. But it is quite scary because it's like it's my own little diary that I've sat there and written and put together, and then I now have just printed loads and sending them all out for everyone to read. So you sit there and you think, why have I done that? But it's still exciting. So yeah, hopefully it's an interesting read and a laugh as well.
Well, I think the overwhelming sense in it is that it's you chatting. And I just wondered whether or not there was, you know, when you were deciding on the style of how it was going to sound, what those conversations were, was there a temptation to make it quite instruction-like, or was it always going to be just Soph having a chat?
Yeah, I really wanted it. And do you know what? One of my followers messaged me and said, I feel like you're in my living room chatting to me.
Yes.
And that was so important to me because I didn't want it to be like this strict manual, and, you know, anyone can just go online and get some tips and hacks and whatever. And that's perfectly fine. That's normal. I mean, I do it. I mean, who don't? Yeah. Who won't research it? But to have a book where it's a bit of fun to it, and it's laid back and it's not too regimented, that's what I wanted. And hopefully if one of my Hinches can just open the book and on one page at least they have a little laugh, then my job's done.
So there are so many laughs, whether that is lovely Jamie, who's we've got Jamie, famous
Mr.
Jamie.
Hinch is in the studio.
The Hinch is in the studio. I'm so honoured. I am. I'm like that. Wow. I'm just disappointed we haven't got a Henry as well.
Oh my God, imagine if he was here. He would love it. He would love it.
Well, I have, because Henry, for those of you who haven't read the book or who are maybe not familiar with Mrs. Hinch, which is increasingly less and less people, Henry is your gorgeous Cocker Spaniel.
He is my fur child.
And do you know what? You have the gloves, don't you? The grooming gloves.
Yes. How amazing are they?
Oh, my God. I saw them at the garage and I thought, they're hilarious. I'll buy them for
amazing.
A joke. And they are incredible.
And he loves it as well.
Yeah.
Like, it's like having a massage.
Just sit there having a massage.
I couldn't think of anything better. If only you'd sit there, Jamie, and, you know, brush my hair with it on. That's an idea. That is an idea.
It is an idea. Yeah. Like a couple of tangle teasers.
That's what
there
I mean.
You go.
You Henry loved it. At first, he was like, what is that? His eyes was like, what? And he loves it.
How has he reacted to the news?
Oh, I mean, being a big brother.
He's being a big brother, is he?
Yeah, do you know what? Bless his heart, he's got no clue what's going on.
No, of course he hasn't.
He just doesn't know what's happening in life. But his life hasn't changed. And that's good. apart from his little bit famous pooch now.
Isn't he? I bet my daughter, my 15-year-old, I now have a 15-year-old who's nearly 16, and we had a Cocker Spaniel called Stanley, the demanding
Cocker
Spaniel.
They're so friendly though, aren't they?
She learnt to walk with his ears. So she was like, literally, she would pull herself up on his ears and walk around.
I mean, they're so friendly. And he's so good with all my friends' babies.
Exactly.
And lots of babies in the family. So, yeah, I think he'll love it.
It'll be great. One of the things that I really loved about the first bit of the book was your love of home.
Yes.
And I think, you know, in this increasing world where we need stuff and bigger houses and but bigger garden and everything, I love the way that you describe home and how that's that special sense of wherever it is. Mm. Where did that come from, do you think?
I mean, on social media nowadays, especially when you're scrolling through your news feed and you're just having a look, every other post it's some perfect looking person or this amazing designer handbag or I must get these shoes or this palace of designer wallpapers and you name it. And I thought to myself, no, like I'm not about that. Like I love nothing more than to go and find a good bargain in a shop, do a cleaning haul and go and do... So, and going home to what, like I say, some people may say it's really boring, but to like all my Hinches know, for me to light my wax melts of an evening, get my candles going, get my blanket out on the sofa with my husband and my dog, I'd rather be doing that than like anything. So the boring life, guys, the boring life is the best life.
It's the way
it starts at home.
It really starts at home. Did you have that with your mum and dad at home? Was home a really central, you know, it was really important for them as well?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, in my book as well, I've mentioned it quite a lot, but I've always been a bit of a worrier and really sensitive. Even when I was at school, you know, when you just worry about things, I used to worry about getting to pee on time or remembering my kit but when I was at home, that all goes, you know, it's just like a place of yours. And
there was a really nice story that you told about a time when your mum picked you up from school and it was raining and they'd locked the door. And I was like,
her voice that day was just like, I've never been so happy to hear my mum's voice. So it was it's nice to have, like I say, little bits like that that you put in a book that, again, I feel like I'd put in my own little diary. So to think that I've printed, there's loads of them going out there now. It's scary, but hopefully you like what you read, guys.
I think it's a really interesting contrast because you are house proud, as you should be, but it's a very zen way to live your life, you know, thinking about and appreciating what you have now, right in front of you. And I just wondered as well, because you've just talked about your Hinches. And I love the way that that's sort of, it's been such an easy word to come out of what you do. This, you're following, it's just all made sense, hasn't it?
I don't understand how this has happened. I never thought my name, like when the day I got married, I never thought my surname would become more or less some
what was
verb.
What was your maiden name?
Barker.
So we can't have the Barkettes, can we? No, the Barks, yeah.
So it's changed from like one, you know, so it's, I can't even believe it. I cannot believe it.
There's a life coach in you. You know, there's this guru, must have the answer to everything. Sometimes there's an interior decorator book on that. There's got to be. No?
I just want to have fun with it all. And I think people are too panicked sometimes and too worried to make it so formal and so regimented and this must be done and you must clean and you must do this. No, like let's just all go with the flow a bit and help each other because we're all in the same boat. We've all got a toilet to clean and a bed to make, so let's all do it together.
Oh, good God alive, the toilets are clean. Is that been a bit of a pressure though, having all the followers that asking you things that, you know, you've all the cleaning routines and the products that you use are all tried and tested by you, and you've gone through that process. But when people start asking you about what do I do about my relationship or how do I organise my time better, was that quite a nerve wracking time to sort of put yourself in that frame?
No, do you know, it really wasn't, because I've said it on my stories a few times and I thought, oh God, I must sound quite stupid, but I feel like my followers as such are like my friends. Like I will share with them things that are not even necessarily cleaning or even Hinching related whatsoever. It's just we talk about random things and they'll message me and we'll just have a chat and I feel like they're my friends, like genuinely feel like they're my friends. So if I was having a low day or not feeling too well, I'll update them and let them know. And they're not even bothered. There could be a day where I'm not cleaning at all, but we're still there for each other. And that's what I can't get my head around, but I love it at the same time because we're just all helping each other.
Do you know what? I went into Morrison's earlier to buy some soda crystals and they'd sold out. And I was like, "Those soda crystals are
hard to get.
I am not joking. This is you, missus. This is you."
But they've been around for donkey years.
I know. It's funny.
I think people think I am. You know, I'm saying, "Oh, I invented these soda crystals." I wish I did. I mean, let's be honest.
Can you imagine?
Gosh. But no, they're just everywhere. I just think it's interesting for all age ranges to sort of become a little bit more familiar with different. I mean, you go to school, yeah. You have geography, history, science, yep. You name it. You don't get told about basic things. It's like, okay. Paying your bills, doing your mortgage, cleaning your
yes,
home,
you're right.
On top of things, like day-to-day normal things. So we're all learning it and winging it together. So we're just having fun with it.
It's really funny because I did think to myself, I will give this to my 16-year-old.
Yeah.
I will because they don't, you know, in the same way that I never listened to my mum about Zoflora. Because yeah. I was like, oh, don't be ridiculous.
I'm going to go now.
It's everywhere. I'm yeah. loving Hello Spring right now.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
I love Hello Spring.
Springtime, have you got that one?
Not yet, no.
Oh, you need. It's even better. Honestly, it's amazing. My favourite one by far.
I've just done the little bottles and put them in the spray bottles. Yes. So I've just got the spray bottle. I went down to the pound shop in Caterham and just bought two little spray bottles and put them in there.
Love that.
It's
love that.
Great.
Yeah.
And a revelation, the pine in the loo. That seems so old school.
I know, right? But it's the smell. Like, I wake up in the morning and I'll be like, right, okay, if I just pine the toilets, I'm on a roll.
Yeah.
So I'll pine the toilets, smell a bit of the floor on the worktops and I'm off. And
yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
Just little things.
Oh, my God. Sorry, I'm so excited to meet you. The other thing that I tried the other day was the squidgy on the carpet.
Oh, my gosh.
for the hair.
Do you know what? It's been around for a long old time, that little
really?
Hair. But I think because I've been blessed with this sort of platform, it, you know, I'm able to share tips and little tricks that have been going yeah. for donkey's years,
yeah.
but we've never knew about it. So I've obviously picked up from somewhere myself over the last year or so, but I tried it out and I thought, oh my God, I've got to share this with my Hinchers. And I have. And then, you know, all of a sudden it's Mrs. Hinch's hack. It's, sorry, guys, it's not, so but it's still a good hack. So let's all just help each other and share.
Let's just help each other.
Yeah.
If you had to try and you know, and sort of trying to unpick things in your head sometimes isn't very helpful. And you know, if you're a worrier and I'm a worrier too, you know, you can kind of get caught up in it. But have you ever, you must have some kind of idea about why then it's happened for you. Why do they listen to you about the squidgy and I won't listen to my mum about the squidgy?
Do you know what I think it is, though? I don't think people even realise how many people are doing all this sort of cleaning and home accounts on Instagram. I mean, when I first started my home account, I'm not going to lie, I was actually a bit embarrassed because I kept behind it. I didn't even tell anyone about it because they must think, oh, you know, get a life. But I loved it. It was a catalogue of my own little success of my home that me and Jamie have saved for years, what feels like years, because renting and saving at the same time so hard. And
yeah.
We got there eventually, skinted ourselves out, but we managed to buy a house and it was my pride and joy and still is. And I love looking after all my little ornaments and I love keeping it clean and I love taking photos of it, memories.
Yeah.
And I put it all on an Instagram account one day because I felt like I was bombarding friends and family on Facebook and it's just gone from there. But I feel like it's a really fun project for people. And if you're thinking of starting an Instagram account yourself, where it's not a case of image and, you know, hair, yeah. makeup and all that, which don't get me wrong, it's amazing. I follow so many of those accounts as well. But it's another avenue for people to explore. And I think it's really fun.
Yeah, it is fun. And I think that's kind of the sort of headline to what you've been doing and to what's happened is that, you know, cleaning is you know, goes it's cleaning / chore. And everybody hears the word chore and goes, oh. But
yeah,
actually,
I dread it.
Yes.
I mean, I honestly love it. Like, I know it sounds so crazy, but I enjoy to clean. I enjoy the results. I enjoy the way it takes my mind off things. And not just that, no matter who you are in this world, no matter if you're in the public eye, or you're not, or you're, you know, whatever, it's a case of it's something we've all got in common.
Yeah.
And we can all share and help each other with it, no matter who you are. And that's it. Like, bleach is bleach, mate. So whether you're famous or not and you're using bleach, that, you know, when we can all do it together, and that's what I love. It's brought so many people together.
Yeah, it's crazy.
So
it's
many
absolutely
people.
Crazy. I love it. There's so when you have you, because you've been doing lots of interviews at the moment, so which requires
yes.
staying in a hotel overnight. What do you pack?
Yeah, well,
what do you pack, just in case?
Well, whatever I do pack, in between each item of clothing is a tumble dry sheet to keep it fresh. Always do that. Like, because then I open up my suitcase and I feel like I can smell home. Is that really sad?
No!
I open it up and I'm like, yeah, home is waiting. I won't be long. But my team, bless them, that helped me, my management team, they're amazing, love them. And they even say, look, so if we know that you don't like to stay away from home, so try and work it out so I don't have to. So I do a couple of days max, then I need to go home because Jamie and Henry and my sofa are just...
There's very few occasions when you don't, where you have to stay away from. My advice to being, I mean, I'm nowhere near as well known as you are,
but
being in it a long time, if people tell you that you've got to stay away for a week, always question it.
Yeah, no, I don't. If I can, and that's the beauty of this account and Instagram is that you can, I can do all this at home.
Yes,
and. Mate, I don't have to leave. So I don't.
It's perfect. Yeah. Have you with Henry, because I am the owner of now, we did have a Cocker Spaniel. I now have a very large brown chocolate Labrador who likes to roll in anything that smells disgusting.
Henry's without the same. Fox as well. Like fox
poo.
Stuff.
The lot. Oh my god, it's disgusting.
I know.
Yeah. I can't believe, and then he comes in and you open the back door and he comes in and I'm just like, I'm just on the floor. God.
Oh, I have it everywhere. And especially when Henry goes out for a run, he comes in, muddy paws on the floor, straight, I can put him in the bath, but that's fine. Then the bath stinks. Now I've got a normal house. I think people think my house doesn't, I've got a dog. I've actually got a real dog, guys. So it does get dirty.
We tried to wash Boo the other day. It was like, literally, it was like some kind of battleground. It was the
like towel. A scene from a film.
It was like a scene from a film. He's like this big. He's a
Beethoven.
Chunk. It was like Beethoven. There was flob and there was, it was literally, I had to have a sit down and a glass of wine afterwards. It was awful. So you don't, I mean, it's not like you go into blind panic when you can't, if you're too busy. No.
And I think that's where some people may think, you know, you shouldn't clean all day, every day. I don't. I actually don't. There's a couple of routines and they're all in my book about the fact of Hinch half hour.
The Hinch half hour, yeah.
Freshen up Fridays, just to make it fun. And like the other day, I was like, Hinches, I haven't cleaned today. Yes, I'm this Mrs. Hinch woman, but I haven't cleaned today. And do you know what? It's all right. Like, it's perfectly fine. I don't want people to put pressure on themselves because then that's when you start not to enjoy it, you know?
Yeah, exactly. And I think that comes like flying through the book as well. It's so not judgmental and you do make a massive effort to kind of say that again and again. And it's also very gender neutral as well. Mm-hmm. Was that a purpose for you? Was intentional to try and do that? Or is you've just never seen it as a woman's job?
No, I'm perfectly honest. It doesn't even cross my mind.
It feels like that.
When people ask me, I don't know whether I'm on a different planet or whether I'm looking at something in the wrong way, but it's not gender specific. Like, regardless of whether you're male, female, or your fur, like fur hinches. I've even got little mini hinches, fur hinches, you name it. It's a toilet. A toilet's a toilet. Like, are you telling me, like, No. So to me, it doesn't even enter my mind. But obviously, everyone's entitled to their opinions. Yep. And, you know, but no. And I've got some amazing male hinches and mini hinches, female hinches, everything.
I'm the dirty dog in our house. My other half is like, and actually we have something in common as well because you like washing up, don't you? Yes,
he
Jamie likes
enjoys
it.
Yeah. It. And I think people think I'm lying, but he actually like enjoys washing up. And I'm not too keen.
I'm not too keen either. My other half, Damien, loves washing up. I've had to fight for a dishwasher. So we've been married, how long have we been married? 16 years. We've been married 16 years. Only last year that we got a dishwasher because he likes washing up and he doesn't like the squeak. Does that make sense?
My gosh, the squeak. Have you got a dishmatic at home? Does he use a dishmatic?
No, he doesn't use a dishmatic.
Oh my gosh, you need a Derek
Schmack. With the little sponge on the end, yes.
And then you can use them for so many different things as well. I put in my book everything that I use it for, like all different reasons and what
grouting.
Products I put in them. Yes. Clean out your bin.
You're a revelation. You're a revelation, woman. You really are. Denture tablets at the end of the night. That's you,
hilarious.
Isn't it?
Dishwasher tablets in the washing machine. Oh, there's loads of little bits and bobs and bits that we've already got at home that we may not think to use. And it's funny because in one of my baskets, I'm obviously quite, you know, everyone knows I
like
basket.
Your basket, yeah.
There were some dishwasher tablets in there and someone messaged me, Mrs. Hinch, I do hope you're okay because you haven't got a dishwasher. And I was thinking, oh, no. But this is what I use them for. You know, you can use them to clean your plugs. You can use them to wash your bath mats, your front door mats, you name it. Yeah, it's fun. Little bits and bobs like that in the book.
And it's such a revelation because I think, you know, in these times where everybody's struggling a bit with austerity and stuff like that, you know, to be able to get your sink looking gorgeous for under a quid is just, it's really fantastic.
Yeah.
Sophie, Mrs. Hinch, congratulations on the book.
Thank you.
I love it. And I love what you do.
Thank you so much.
Never change and keep doing it. And I wish you all the success. Thanks for coming into the Magic Book Club.
All the best, Magic. Thank you so much.
Actually, I need to ask you one more question.
Right.
Can I just ask for one more question? Yes. We are Magic Radio.
Yes.
I noticed on your playlist.
Yes.
There are a lot of songs that we play on Magic.
Do you know what? Magic, you're magic. I love it. I tune in. I do listen in. And you're magic for a reason. So happy Hinch in magic is all I can say.
Thank you.